Welcome back to a new video, and in this video I'm gonna show you how you can use encrypted shared preferences to store your small piece of information which is very secure. So let's get started without wasting any time. So here, first thing first, I'm gonna put dependencies in order to access encrypted shared preferences in our project. So this is the dependency. Alright, so now it's time to create a different file for that, and the file name is cryptic pref. So this is a class, and in this class I'm having a function get shared preferences. So return type of this thing is shared preferences. So first we have to create a master key. Now this master key is actually used to encrypt and decrypt our information. So use your master key. Actually in this we have a builder pattern. So in this builder we have to pass the context. So if you press Ctrl P, see requirement is context. So from this function get share preferences, I'm gonna pass context. Now use it in here. Next we have set key scheme. Now here you have to pass your master key scheme. So use your master key scheme, and in this I'm gonna use AES256_GCM. So this is my key scheme. If you want to pass anything else you can do it very easily, it's not a big deal. Next we have set user authentication required. So suppose you want to attach this shared preferences to authentication, how can you do that? So let's take a very simple example. Suppose your mobile application require fingerprint authentication. If user is not authenticated, on that case you are not able to access your shared preferences. If it is authenticated, then only you are able to perform shared preferences operations. So here I'm gonna pass false because I don't want to attach this thing with any other authentication. So for that I'm gonna attach one parameter, is user authenticated, type is boolean. Now simply pass in here is user authenticated. Next you can pass the duration, so how much duration you want to give the authentication to the user. So for me, basically I'm not using this, but still I'm gonna pass here 5 minutes, which is 300 seconds. Next we have set key generator parameter specification. So here you can mention the specification how you want to generate your parameter. Okay, by the way I'm not using this. Next we have set request strong box back. So if you want to provide the backup from the strong box to your shared preferences, you can do that thing very easily with the help of set request strong box back. By the way, strong box is a different component which present in the user device. Some of the Android device have strong box and some of the device don't. So if you are certain that your Android device have strong box, then only you can pass it in here true. Otherwise simply use false. So strong box is used to store very sensitive information. So what it will do, it will simply provide you backup. Okay, so lastly I'm gonna simply build it. Now it's time to create our share preferences. So for that I'm using here encrypted share preferences dot create, and in this if you check the parameters we have to pass context. Next we have to pass the file name. So I'm gonna call this my cryptic pref. Next we have to pass our master key. Next we have here preferences key encryption scheme, I mean how you want to encrypt your key. So in preferences we are having two things, key and value. So this key encryption scheme you can give here. So for that I'm using here pref key encryption scheme AES256_SIV. Similarly for the value I'm using here pref value encryption scheme AES256_GCM. Okay, so now we have our shared preferences. Now simply return this thing from here. Okay, so we are done with our get shared preferences. Now on the top I'm gonna create a variable naming pref, initialize this thing with lazy, get shared preferences, pass your context. Now this context is coming from here, so private while context. Next we have to pass one more variable which is user authenticated, type is boolean. Now simply pass context and is user authenticated. Okay, so make sure this is a private function. And now I'm gonna create a function to put values, so put string. In this we have to pass our key. Next the value type is string. Now it's time to use our pref. Pref edit put string, pass your key and value, simply use apply. Next if you want to fetch it we have another function like get string, pass your key and it will give you string. Return pref dot get string, pass your key. Next we have to pass default value, so which is empty string, and if it is null, simply pass empty string. So this is our cryptic preferences. Now it's time to use it. So go to your main activity, and in this main activity on the bottom I'm going to create a composable, and I'm going to call this main screen. Now in this main screen I want a reference of my pref, which is cryptic pref. So first I'm going to create here few text field. Basically for the key we have one text field, for the value we have second text field. So within the column, make sure to use a modifier fill max size, and its vertical arrangement on the center and its horizontal alignment is also on the center. Okay, now in this I'm going to create a text field. So this is for the key. Now in order to hold the state, we have two things. First we have key state, remember mutable state of empty string. Similarly for the value we are having one more state, so remember mutable state of empty string. Simply import this. Okay, now simply use it in here, key dot value, and in on value change use key dot value. I'm using here modifier padding horizontally 16 dp, and yeah, pretty much done with this. Now I'm gonna add a spacer having modifier height of 12 dp. Just below to it I'm having one more text field, so instead of creating it, simply copy this stuff, paste in here, and this time we have value. Now if anything got changed, our value state will be updated. Again I want spacer, modifier height of 12 dp. Just below to it we have button, and the button says save info, and when user click on it, I'm using my pref, use put string in place of key, I'm using my key value in place of value, I'm using value dot value. All right, so now what will happen if I want to see the value is present in our shared preferences or not? So for that I'm gonna create one more button, and this time its UI says get info, and when user click on it, I'm using my pref, we have here get string, simply use your key value, and we are going to show this information in the text. Now in this text we have to pass the string value that we are receiving from the shared preferences. So for that on the top I'm going to create one more state, and the state name is stored value, remember mutable state of empty string. Now when we fetch the information, simply use your stored value and update it. Okay, now in this text I'm using my stored value, and for the style I'm using here material theme typography headline large, and also make some space, modifier height of 12 dp. here again I'm using a spacer, modifier height of 12 dp. I think we are pretty much done with our screen. Now it's time to use it. So use in here in place of modifier, just use modifier and pass the inner padding that we are receiving from this scaffold, and lastly we have to pass the cryptic pref. On the top I'm going to create a variable naming pref, initialize the thing lazily with the help of cryptic pref. Requirement of this thing is two. First we have to pass the context, next is user authenticated, so I'm using here false. Now pass it in here. Alright, so yeah, we are pretty much done. Now I'm going to execute this application in my Pixel 7a API level 33. Alright, so our app is executing. Now in the key, I'm simply putting here key, in the value I'm using value new. Now save the information, and when I click this get info, here you can see value new. Now I want to store one more information, so for the key I'm using here key one, for the value I'm using value new one. Save it, and when you click this get info, see value new one. Now I'm gonna show you where this information is stored. So for that, open up your device explorer. Let me minimize this thing. So make sure to choose your emulator. Now I'm gonna choose one more time so that it will refresh everything. Okay, so here open up this data. In this data, open up your data one more time. Choose your package name. So logically, every time when you create any application, you will receive the package information at the bottom. So simply scroll to the bottom. This is our package name, Gaur Himanshu Encrypted Shared Preferences. Simply open it up. So we have here shared preferences. Okay, so open it up. My cryptic preferences. So this is the name that I have given to my encrypted shared preferences. Now open it up. See, all of the key value pair is in the encrypted form. So you are not able to see the key and value, and also you are not able to understand. So by using this, you can prevent your shared preferences. You can make more complex for reverse engineering. I hope you like this video. It's a very simple video, but at the same time, if you want to increase security of your application, these are things that you should keep in mind. Okay, so we'll meet in our next video. Till that, goodbye. Have a nice day.